We're ready.
We are ready.
All ready. So whenever you start talking, we'll go for it.
All right, Pastor. Welcome, KCWG The Truth listeners. I am Mr. Unbreakable, Pastor Brian Warren, and this is my wife, Prophet Gina Guy-Warren.
Welcome, everybody. We are Truth and Love Ministry International, also known as
the Facebook,
hashtag
Facebook Pastors.
Wait, should we do the sign? Hashtag.
Okay, there we go.
People won't think I'm throwing like gang signs, will they?
Nope.
This isn't like a gang sign, or is it?
No, that's the hashtag festival.
Oh, hashtag. There's no gangs that do like hashtags, are there?
I hope not.
We don't want to throw signs out other than signs and wonders. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
All right. Well, welcome. We are on live on KCWG The Truth Radio. And,
wow.
Oh, I think we got Pastor Starks talking on there too. So we just turn that one down. Yeah. All right. So we are broadcasting. We always broadcast from a remote location, you guys. So it's an awesome thing to add our Facebook listeners, Truth and Love Ministry, our team Unbreakables. Hey, we had a pretty awesome, we call it a weekend, but it felt like a weekend, but today's Thursday for our anniversary, right?
Yes, we did.
There we go.
Yeah,
we just need to put him down. I'm going to turn the volume down all the way. Yeah, we got a little bit of feedback going from the radio station, so we're sorry about that, you guys. Hey, give us a little jot on the screen there if the video's looking good. And if I'm looking good, no, I'm just joking. let me know how I look. I'm just kidding. We just want to make sure we're the lighting here, and we're getting a lot of feedback from you guys. We love it. We're hearing when the videos are so clear and they look fantastic. And then, you know, we hear if it looks like a little fuzzy, and I can't hear. You need to turn down your volume on that one. Yeah. Okay, sorry. We have a few distractions going on. All right. So anyway, we love to hear from where you're coming from, what, where are you guys coming from? What area are you in and all of that kind of stuff. So, okay. So it looks like the video, our videos are looking good. So we appreciate that. And you know, y'all can go to YouTube under Prophet Gina Guy Warren. And that way you can watch all of the messages that we've uploaded. My husband's on the side there taking care of a few things. So, oh, there he is. Wait, there he is. And there he's not. And then he's back in the screen.
I'll be back.
And there he's gone. Go. All right. He's working with KCWG right now. Hello from Illinois. Nice to see you guys. North Carolina. Love you guys. And South Carolina. We are in Southern California. So we are loving your feedback sincerely. The encouragement we're hearing from you guys. I mean, wow, a lot of prophetic dreams. You're receiving impartation. You're watching the videos. You're feeling the glory of God, the presence of the Lord. And, you know, I've been doing this for a number of years, and you always hear, oh, you know, the glory of God. But the true glory, you know, the glory of God has come when actually something changes in your life. It's not about goosebumps and feelings and speaking in tongues and all that kind of stuff, right? The anointing breaks the yoke of bondage. And so that's what we pray, is that the anointing would break the yoke on your lives. And we're going to talk about today. I mean, sincerely, it's Christians that really are yoked. They're unequally yoked, and they're just yoked with a lot of burdens. And this is why Pastor Brian and I really have a passion to clean the swamp waters of the church, because you know, we receive numerous calls and a lot of our counseling, and you guys, it's all Christians. It's all false prophets and pastors coming into people's lives and causing pain and all kinds of things. So this is our mandate. This is what we do. You know, you got to stay in your lane and know what your great thing is. You know, I was thinking about even the woman in the Old Testament, and Elisha said that there was a woman. She was a great woman. And, you know, just said she was great. And that's what's so awesome is, you know, we just want to be great at that one thing. You know, what's the one thing God's given you to do? Just be great at it. You know, focus on that. Have extreme focus and be great at that. And, you know, my husband's on the phone, but I took a picture of what I wanted to, let me see. I think if I could pull it up on this phone, or my husband. But he's still on the phone over there. So we're just rolling with all this tonight, you guys. So stick with us. We received a message from one of our partners, and I took a picture of it, and I wanted to speak it to you, but it's on the phone that's recording right now, so I don't have it unless my husband has it, what Deborah had spoken. But anyway, one of our partners wrote in, and before Pastor Brian and I left for our anniversary, our Clashing of the Swords, year of the Clashing of the Swords, our 2-2-2 wedding anniversary, our two-year anniversary, she wrote in and said that she had a dream, and we were up on a tower, and Brian and I was holding a water bottle, and it said focus, and she said she was so excited. This dream was just amazing, and the Lord was speaking to her to really focus on what this ministry is teaching. Focus on it. Know what we're teaching. And
We're back.
I've been here. You was gone. You were like scooting all over the place.
Technical difficulties. We're back live. KCWG, the truth.
We already did that, honey.
I'm doing it again.
You want to do it again?
My wife, Prophet Gina Guy-Warren. Ready? Roll tape.
Take three. Three, three, three.
There we go.
Take three. All right. But we were talking about Deborah, one of our partners. And I just like to call all you guys out. We just get so many messages from you guys. We just love it. But the dream that she'd had and the vision and God told her just to really focus on what this ministry is teaching. And the Lord's going to confirm that too if you're partners of this ministry, because we really are teaching in the vein of what Holy Spirit is attempting to really teach all of us. We have to have a now word for the season we're in. The times are perilous. The upheaval, the uprivals, the rebellion in the streets, the rioting, the corruption, and the protesting, all of it. I mean, it's not going to get better. Just read your Bible. You know, the Bible says when you see the earthquakes and fires and signs and mother rises against daughter and sister against brother and those kinds of things that you know you're in the end of times. And so we are. And so we need to get with end time leaders that are teaching us what God is speaking. So, Brian, we've been in the series, in a really awesome series that God had put on my heart to teach everybody. And so the series is called Recognizing Our Spiritual Parents, Keys to Accessing Our Destiny. So I just want to give like the little prelude to the message for those that will be watching this, because these are going to thousands. I mean, you guys are sharing this, you know, once it hits like a couple thousand on Facebook, which is sometimes within 24 hours, we upload it to YouTube, Prophet Gina Guy Warren, and all of our partners that are watching this, when you guys disconnect from us, you're sharing it right away, but you're sharing it public. You're not sharing it private just to your friends. You're releasing your settings on your Facebook page, and you're saying share, post, public. And I love that because it's a mega church here.
Yeah, we...
So many people.
The listeners and the following that's starting to come about is pretty phenomenal. I mean, last week's message, I think, hit 1,000 views within less than 6 hours.
Yeah, within six.
So that's the most we've had. And so, yeah, it's pretty exciting to see that.
It's exciting because we know that we're teaching exactly what God is asking us to teach. And more than that, we're seeing fruit from our labor. We're seeing fruit from the work of our hands. And the fruit is you. Amen. Did I just call them a bunch of fruits?
Good fruit.
I just call them a fruit.
Good fruit.
Yeah. All the fruit is in our Team Unbreakable partners. I mean, because I love that you take the time to tell us what's going on.
Amen.
But I think we should do a show, probably an interim between this, after this one and the contaminated finance that we get into. We should do just a partners one and question and answers live on the radio and do all that kind of stuff and just let you guys share, and that would be awesome. But the first message when we started this, you know, because we're talking about the difference between legitimate and illegitimate children in the church. The title of message one was The Characteristics of a Leader Who Cares for Your Soul. That was our first message. The second message was Vision Delay, the Sheep Play. When an impatient church removes the pastor from God's presence, you'll definitely want to watch that on YouTube. And then last week's message was When Your Leader Takes Your Tithes and Makes a Calf. Remain silent, God's about to speak. So today, what the Lord really spoke to me about teaching on We're in Exodus 32. We're camping out right there. And the title of today's message, it's February 23rd, 2017.
The day after our anniversary.
I know.
Some of you guys got to see that fun. We had a great time.
At the castle.
Took her to the castle.
Yes, you did, honey.
It was amazing.
Oh, we had so much fun. We just posted the album on there. You guys can see it. And people were seeing so much prophetic stuff. Like, this is a book cover. You know, the presence of God's all over this one. The glory of God. This is a, you know, revelatory picture. But, you know, what I don't know that people really understand is, you know, God is using all the arts. He uses all of the arts. And my husband is very creative with his collages and seeing things and pictures, as well as myself. So can you imagine together when we take pictures? You know, people were asking, who was your photographer yesterday? We're like, us. We did it. And but it's awesome because God is speaking through these photos. We're not ones to just put a picture up and just say, oh, do we look cute? Because it's so not about that. We, you know, oh my gosh, I'm so not like that.
But you did look cute yesterday, so.
Well, you looked amazing. You look handsome, like a warrior. Somebody said you look like an emperor.
High five.
I missed. But we are pretty tired, so pray for our strength. We have not stopped ministering, even when we leave. But we're going to get into that, because we're going to talk about some personal stories today. But let's dive into the word. Pastor Brian, you want to pray for the minds and the hearts and the ears of our listeners to open to receive revelation, not information tonight.
Yes, Father, in the name of Jesus, Father, we thank you, Lord, for all the listeners on KCWG The Truth Radio. And we also thank all the listeners, the Team Unbreakables, that are following us on all the social media sites as well. Father, open up their minds, open up their hearts to be able to receive this message. And thank you, Lord, that you download the information and the revelation to your daughter, Lord, your prophet, to be able to send this out to your people. We thank you, Lord, for the trust.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
And we thank you for using us, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Bless this message.
Bless it. In Jesus' name. Amen. And we had two salvations on our last message. So, listen, you guys, God's adding to the numbers of this church, this ministry. People are getting saved. They're getting filled with the Holy Ghost with the evidence of speaking in tongues. They're getting set free from depression, drug abuse, all that kind of stuff. So we want to let you guys know what's happening, because, you know, especially when you're part of a ministry and it's not a church building, it's an online church. You know, it's very difficult sometimes, like, oh, what are they doing? What's happening? Well, today you're going to hear some stuff. But again, Exodus 32, the attempt right now is to read verses 9 through about 15. So we've just been chewing this and breaking it up, right? So I'm going to go ahead and read it, and then we're going to go back, okay? So God bless the reading of his word, because when his word goes forth, that's what sets us free, and it separates our own intentions, our own motives, our own thoughts, and all of that. So it's his word that's going to go forth. What's so funny? Somebody doing something? Oh, they're so cute. I know. We have such great Bereans. They're like scribes.
I'm laughing at the comments because they're always talking about my wife's hair.
Is my hair again?
Yeah, it's the hair again.
Hair.
She's got Jesus hair. Listen, we have an amazing hair. She has an amazing hairdresser that does her hair now.
Yeah.
And
the Naughty Salon.
Oh my goodness!
I have everything on my other phone, on this phone. But the Naughty Salon in Susan City. Did I say it right?
Sassoon.
Sassoon. I'm so California. Like, I'm so Valley. I'm so Southern California. I don't know how to say.
Naughty Hair.
And her name is Sherry Johnston with a T. Sherry Johnston.
She's probably watching.
We invited her on today. We just ministering to all kinds of people, you guys. So the Lord always positions you for a purpose, always positions you for souls.
She cut my hair too.
Amen, I know.
God bless you, Sherry.
Talk about how handsome he looks.
God bless you, Sherry.
But thank you for the... I think my hair looks good. I don't know. Okay, but let's see how good God's word looks right now.
Amen.
This is phenomenal.
Same about your hair, and that's about the word.
Amen.
Let's do it.
I still like the compliments. It's pretty nice,
though.
Yeah.
You look beautiful.
Okay, here we go. So we're starting with verse 9 of 32. And so the Lord says to Moses, I've seen this people, and behold, they're stiff-necked. So God is speaking to his minister. God's speaking to his prophet. God's speaking to his pastor, his priest. God says, I've seen you guys. You're stiff-necked. You're rebellious. You're wicked. Oh, God, let God never say that about
Lord
us.
Have
Amen.
Mercy.
Now, oh, he will, because we are their Facebook pastors and we pray for mercy for them. But let's get into that.
Amen.
Verse 10. Now, therefore, let me alone. God says, like, go. Leave me alone. That my wrath may burn hot against them, and that I might destroy them, and I will make you a great nation. But Moses pleaded with the Lord, his God, and said, Lord, why does your wrath blaze hot against your people, whom you've brought forth out of the land of Egypt with great power and a mighty hand? And why should the Egyptians say, for evil he brought them forth? Slay them in the mountains and consume them from the face of the earth. Turn from your fierce wrath and change your mind concerning this evil against your people. Oh my gosh, I don't want to stay there, but I'll go back to that. Change your mind, God. Change your mind, God. Earnestly remember Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, your servants, to whom you swore by your own self, and say to them, I will multiply your seed as the stars of the heaven, and all this land that I've spoken, I will give to you and your seed, and you'll inherit it. So the Lord turned from the evil which he had thought to do his people. And Moses turned and went down from the mountain with the two tablets of the testimony in his hands that were written on both sides. Amen. All right, here we go. You guys ready to dig into this? Because it's so important that all of us have spiritual parents. Again, I don't want to backtrack because we want to keep moving forward. So again, anybody that's listening to this or thinking, oh gosh, well, my parents hurt me, even my natural parents, and this church, you know, I was listening to this guy for years, and he blessed me, but now he's Oprah Winfrey's best friend. Oh, sorry.
Oh, dang.
And tolerates homosexuality and says it's okay and all this kind of stuff, right? So I just don't want to put my trust in leaders. Listen, that's the enemy's ploy. That's what the devil does, because he will always use the very thing that is going to bring us into destiny. A spiritual parent is the key to accessing your destiny. So, of course, he's going to turn us against spiritual parents and against the church. You're not going to turn me against it, but we're here to claim the swamp waters of the church and make a difference and teach you that there is a better way. There are very, very awesome pastors, prophets, teachers, evangelists, you know, in the body of Christ, and we just need to learn how to identify them. So when we start, right? Yeah. So when we start and we look at what ends up happening, I love verse 11. This is where I kind of want to start, right? Verse 11, but Moses, I love it. He besought or he pleaded with the Lord. And he's like, why are you so ticked off at these people? And so basically, Brian, the Lord's like, duh. Do you think God says duh? He's like, duh. Duh. They're building calves. I'm so ticked off. And God's like, I'm done. I'm over it. Anybody that's a parent will know exactly what I'm talking about. It. When your children act a fool, you've told them 100 times what to do, and they're like, I'm over it. I'm done. You're grounded for life. You know, I'm going to keep you locked up in your room until you're 18. Anybody who has children and has disciplined children, you are going to understand how Father God feels in this scripture with the rebellious Israelites.
My poor mom.
Your poor mom, I know.
She used to put me in the room, and then I was out like 3 seconds later, jumped out the window.
Are you serious?
That was me, yeah.
So you had a stiff neck? You're rebellious?
Stiff neck, stiff butt.
Stiff
that.
Butt, stiff everything?
Spankings. You name it, she got me with it.
Oh, dang. Thank you, Mama Doris.
Switches, hangers.
Oh, dang. Bless her.
She made me tougher, though.
Yeah, he's a tough baby. But, you know, and so the whole point is, so now Moses is going before God, and he's saying, please. He's pleading. So I don't know about you, but I know when my children, there's times when they just go, please, Mom. And there's times they're like, please, Mom, please. Oh, God, my God. Please don't do this. Please don't put me on restriction. Please, 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 please. You know, Friday I was supposed to do this. Or, please, please. And they plead with you. That's the heart of Moses for the people right now. He was pleading for the sins of the people. Your pastor should be pleading for your sin before God. Your pastor, your church leader, your spiritual parent needs to be a person that will why am I getting that look?
We did that today. We prayed. We pleaded with God today for go to sleep, Sam.
Yeah.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we
had somebody that we really care about called us today and trying to enjoy our anniversary.
Yes.
And we're taking ministry calls.
Yes.
And, but we haven't heard from this person in a very long time. Months and months and months. Yeah. The special effects in the background.
Special effects. That's Sam the protector dog in the background. But yeah, I mean, what you were saying is, okay, so this is what I want to explain. I want to share a couple things and then explain why this message is about when your leader seeks favor on behalf of your sin. I want to tell the partners, this is what I heard when I was praying this morning. Like, I literally just started speaking to the Father, and within seconds, this is what he told me. He said, power, purpose, and presence is released on your behalf. So the Lord said, listen, Gina, when people listen to their spiritual leaders, when they're obedient, like Deborah said, I got in the dream that I was supposed to make sure, or not her, she said, all of our Team Unbreakables, they need to understand we need to focus on exactly what you're teaching. She's being obedient to her spiritual parents, and she's also letting the other children know, hey, Mama and Papa are speaking, we need to really listen. And I love that, but that's been so abused in the church house. And I think that's, you know, but I don't want to go about all the abuse right now. Today, well, we're going to touch on some of it, but today I really want to make sure we're focusing, like right now, on this particular part, that in verse 11, Moses really sought the Lord. And then in verse 12, he's basically saying, Brian, listen, these people have come this far. Lord Jesus, Team Unbreakable, they've been listening to us. They've been writing us. They've been sharing, their faith is increased, they're financially sowing, they're tithing, they're being obedient, Lord. But I know this particular person or some of, you know, what I'm praying, I'm seeing this or that, and I'm asking you to have mercy on their rebellion. I'm asking you to have mercy on the sin that I am seeing. Please have mercy on that. Listen, when Moses went before God and did that, I love it. He didn't want Brian, I think the best way to say it is our motives as leaders should be, and I know ours are, that the number one person that gets glorified is God. Not that people are listening to us and there's, when Moses said, listen, why should you discipline them? Let your wrath burn so great, because listen, you just delivered them out of Pharaoh's kingdom. So do you want the enemy, their enemies, to say, oh my gosh, so God brought them this far just to destroy them? See, I believe that Moses was more concerned about the reputation of God than the people. A true spiritual leader fears not man and his religion or what the church will think and what we care what you guys think, if you don't like us, if you don't like my hair, if you don't like what we say, how we do. No, our first priority is, Lord Jesus, please have mercy on our listeners. Have mercy on our partners, because they've come so far and they've believed. So don't let your wrath burn on their sin. And so I love that in verse 13, he then says, earnestly remember. So God, so Moses, the pastor, is saying, number one, please don't burn them up. They all rebellious. They're all clubbing. They're all sleeping around. They're tolerating sin. You know, they're out drinking and getting drunk. You know, whatever, all these different things that we tend to, whatever sins we fall into, they're tending to be real prideful and they're being real judgmental. And I see some of the posts, Lord, and man, like today on one of our honeymoon pictures, I'm out in the water in my bikini, like way out in the water, and someone said, cover that sinful flesh. Oh dear God. I was like, ora ramasaya. I mean, you know, so your heart goes out to people when they speak like that. To call your flesh sinful tells me they don't have a good marriage, they don't have a good body image. You know, there's a difference between being seductive and trying to show your body parts in a bathing suit. And there's another thing, like you're out in the water on your honeymoon. But
should have been wearing a parka in the water.
I should have. It was 150 degrees, and pastors should wear parkas. Pastors shouldn't have any freedom.
That was our honeymoon, wasn't it?
Yeah, that was on our honeymoon in Mexico.
I'm glad you weren't wearing a parka in the water.
Thank you, Jesus.
I'm just saying.
Yeah, but, you know, but what the oh, no, somebody says, oh, no. But the point is, this person follows our ministry a lot. Like, they post a lot of stuff and say really nice stuff, and all of a sudden it was like vomit came out of this person's mouth. So Lord Jesus, forgive this person's religious thinking that a pastor should be wearing, you know, a parka at the beach or what have you. So, you know, and so we cover her sin and his sin. We cover their sin as leaders. Now, they're not financial partners. They don't financially support us, but they will say things on our posts. So we covered them. And that's what you need to understand. That's exactly what we need to do. And I love it. So that's what Moses did, right? The first thing he said was, oh, Lord, no, but please don't do this to them. Then the second thing he said was that why should the enemies gloat over your Christian people? You know, your church, like, don't let the devil get any ground. Don't get mad. I know they blew it, but we don't want the devil to excel or, you know, or have anything on your people. So don't do it. And then the third thing, he starts to bring up Abraham, Isaac, you know, the servants prior. I love that. And Moses had such a good picture of covering God's people and the fear of the Lord. And that's what your spiritual leader, if they cover your sin, I am not talking about you're in the pulpit committing adultery, and now all of a sudden you divorce that person, you marry the new one in 3 months, and now it's legal adultery, and I'm covering your sin. I'm not talking about that. You know, we all sin and fall short of the glory of God. So that's when your spiritual parent goes before the Lord, they blew it. You know, please help them. And that's one of the things that Pastor Brian was bringing up today is, you know, people ask about, do you guys tolerate homosexuality? Do you still love them? Are you loving towards them? Do you embrace them? And absolutely not tolerate, but we absolutely embrace everybody, not their belief system or their sin. We embrace them. And so what Pastor Brian was explaining, and we like to tell some of these stories so people kind of know who we are, because we're not in a church building. They don't see us operating in a church building and seeing all those kinds of counseling appointments come in and out of the church and stuff like you would your pastor in a local church body. And this particular woman came into our lives, you know, a few months ago. And long and the short of it, we had to hold, I was watching her one day. I had her in my home and I was watching her freak out. I got to get on this phone call. I'm like, what's wrong with her? And make the long story even longer, Pastor Brian, she was paying $1,000 a month to a very popular ministry, if I named it. And she was getting on conference calls with this man, Sharp, because that was her spiritual parent, paying him $1,000. Do you know this girl was a prostitute? Do you know this girl was having a very hard time, a Christian? She was spirit-filled, prayed in tongues, had a beautiful heart, sweet, sweet woman of God, full of power, knew the word, but she was turning tricks because she was bound. We loved her. We embraced her. We prayed for her. She, you know, we covered her. I fed her in my home. I moved her and her daughter in for free as a single mom, a single woman, and covered her and took care of her to help her. But I got on the phone with that leader. Oh, they blocked me on Facebook and all that, but I let them know, why would you take money from someone that actually suffers from prostitution? She's paying you just like she pays her pimps. You are a spiritual pimp. That's exactly what you are. You are a spiritual pimp. You're pimping this woman. And why are you charging her $1,000 a month for spiritual coaching? Now, this wasn't counseling. This wasn't, let's dig deep into why you're having trouble turning tricks. This was teaching her the word and making her pay for it. And oh, you bet, better believe I got on top of that and stopped that right away. They even made her empty out her 401k and give all the money to this person's ministry. So see, this is why we talk like we do. If you guys are curious, like what gives you the authority or whatever. So I have been praying for her. I love this woman. And if this ministry had the funds in our account today, we would have not given her the money. We would have booked an airline ticket and we would have said, check in to such and such airport in your state. I want you on a plane. We will have a car pick you up. We are going to move you into this particular house and we're going to keep you there till you get delivered and set free from turning tricks. But because the ministry at this point doesn't have that kind of finances, we couldn't do it. We had to hang up on the phone and she admitted to me she still had to go prostitute tonight. so that she could pay her rent where she was. You know, so listen, you guys, we're covering her, and so I'm not giving you her name. I'm asking, thank you, Deborah, for that. I saw that post just go up. All I'm going to ask you is to, you know, pray for Sister S. Pray for Sister S. Pray for her to get set free. And, you know, but we can pray like that, but ministries need, true ministry needs these kind of finances that we can help these kind of people. So, yes, I love this prostitute, full of the word, full of the Lord, full of power, and full of tongues. And it just makes me really mad that these ministries prostituted her and took her money. You never have somebody empty a 401k when they can't even, she was a single mom, she couldn't even take care of her daughter. But now this ministry took this money.
And my wife reminded me that that if it wasn't for her, this yes. prostitute, that I would probably still be bound. I could.
That's a whole nother story, right? Yeah, you would. Yep.
I might not even be here right now.
No, for sure. No. I don't know if Pastor Brian's ever told that story, and I know, you know, like again, here's the disclaimer for anybody who's new watching this particular Recognizing Your Spiritual Parents series. We started this series letting you know that we were going to flow with the Holy Ghost, that we wanted to do as he said. If we didn't get through Exodus 32, then oh well, something we're going to say is going to save a life. And, you know, when Pastor Brian was a friend, and I had a 4,000 square foot home, I lived there by myself, so I had 5 bedrooms. I never took anybody in because I never wanted my anointing in my home disturbed. I never wanted the atmosphere disturbed. I don't want your funky spirit coming in my house. I don't want you turning on my TV and then I got to pray all night because some damn spirit came through your TV show. So I never took in roommates that, and I needed the money and I could have rented out 4 other bedrooms. Okay. But having said that, Brian had lost his apartment that he was in. I had taken in this prostitute. And one of my daughters was going to be moving in as well. So there was total accountability. I moved Pastor Brian in into this house. So we had 3 of us at that time when you were there. Brian decided, you know, he was still going to play with the world and go play with the Jezebel spirits. So one day Pastor Brian just gets mad at me, which... go ahead, dude. You're just fighting Jesus. You're not fighting me. So go ahead and pack your bags and move out. I don't care. And so he leaves and he'll tell that part of the story. But I stayed in intercession for him. I did not know he was my husband at the time. Guarantee that. And I just stayed interceding for him, interceding. And the Lord gave me a scripture. Simon, Simon, Satan has asked to sift you as wheat. But I have prayed that your faith would not fail you. When you are strengthened and you return, go and strengthen your brothers. So that's what Jesus said to Peter, Simon, Simon. He didn't call him by Peter. His name hadn't been changed yet. He's going to call him by his worldly name, Simon, Simon. So actually, Pastor Brian, I have Holy Ghost chills. This teaching does go with, because I was your spiritual parent, so to speak. You were tithing to the ministry. I wasn't charging you rent. You needed help. You came in for free. However, you were tithing to the ministry what you could. And so I was covering you as a spiritual parent would do. So that day, Sister S was walking by the bottom of the stairs. I was coming down. I said, stop right now. I need you to pray with me. I need you to pray. She stopped and started praying in tongues with me. I felt like Brian was literally slipping into hell. He was going to hell that day. I felt that Brian was going to die that day. And so I began praying in tongues. So did Sister S. And as soon as we felt it break, okay, she went to her room, went to bed, and I went to my room, I went to bed, and Pastor Brian, he never came home. Right?
Eventually came home.
Well, but that night, yeah. But yeah. Then I think it might have been the next day. I think it was the next day.
Like
you were gone for 3 days.
It's like 3 or 4 in the morning. And I have no idea how I got back to that house. Mm-mm. No idea. All I know is I must have crawled in to the front door.
Amen.
And,
yes.
And then all I could say was pray over me. And yeah, it's tough to even think about, guys, because this is a true story.
And you were a Christian. Life. You were already a Christian and saved.
I've been a Christian. I've been a Christian for, I don't know, 15 years. But Here's the thing, though. Like, what people don't know is there's a lot of Christians out there that are still bound and are still suffering from things that they haven't found the roots. They can still be Christians. But there's sometimes there's a root that's so deep.
Amen.
Like, that's why people get root canals, right? You can brush your teeth and floss your teeth all you want.
Preach it.
But if there's something that's dead inside of there, or something that needs to be pulled out,
amen,
that's affecting everything else.
Hallelujah.
You need to find it,
mm-hmm,
pinpoint it, pull it out by the
extract
root.
Extract it.
And that's what she did. I mean, there was something left in me, you know, something left in me that just wanted a piece of the world.
Amen.
Still wanted a little bit of the world.
Yes.
And I'm going to tell you right now, I got it. That was the night I got it. That was the night I got everything from the world. And I literally thought I was going to die.
I felt it, praying for you.
If I didn't come back to that house and have Prophet Gina Guy-Warren, well, she wasn't my wife at the time, pray over me, I would have slipped and something would have happened to me.
It's true.
I don't even want to tell you what the things that were going through my mind, what I was doing. It's not the point, but the thing is, mm-hmm, that I came back. And when I realized that was the only place that I could go for safety and,
amen,
that to be truly delivered, it was almost like it's almost that the Lord allowed me to get that close
to hell.
To get that close, because it was the last thing that left in me. And it was so much revelation that came to me after she prayed over me. And I remember sitting at the table the next day with her and this person.
Yes.
And I just couldn't stop weeping. I could not stop crying. The Lord was just downloading. And this happened. And,
yes.
And that was the last bit that I needed.
That root, you got extracted.
Yeah. No, I didn't want to. I don't want to taste hell anymore. And I knew that the Lord was giving me one more chance, one last chance to get it right. To get it right. And if I didn't, then yeah, he was going to let the devil just take me out.
And we want to let all of our listeners know we are a safe place to be healed and restored and protected. And, you know, you can go to tnlmi.org. Our mission statement, our vision statement is on the website, okay? So you want to know what your spiritual parents stand for. You need to know, you know, are they tolerant towards the things of the world? Will they stand firm and speak the truth and not compromise it? Are they like Moses? Will they go before God? And I pray the connection's not getting disconnected or whatever. But, you know, will they go before the Lord and on my behalf? And, you know, I want to read you something about Job, what Job did. In Job chapter 1, verse 5, "And when the days of feasting were over, Job sent them to purify and hallow them, and he rose up early in the morning and offered burnt offerings according to the number of all of his children. For Job said, 'It may be that my sons have sinned and cursed or even disowned God in their hearts. Thus did Job at all such times.'" Now, we pray for you in Jesus' mighty name. If you have disowned God in your heart, you may be sitting in a church every Sunday. You may be sitting at home saying, "I'm a Christian," but in your heart, you've disowned God. We cover you in the blood of Jesus Christ. And everyone at the sound of our voices now, we cover you with the blood of Jesus. And we beseech the Lord. We cry out to God on your behalf. We ask, oh God, have mercy on your rebellious children. Have mercy on those that are turning their hearts away from you. Because of Exodus 34, 6 through 9. So I'm saying these scriptures, and I know our team Unbreakables are writing them down, and our KCWG listeners are hearing. Because this is what people need to understand. I'm going to touch on something, And my hairdresser and I, we spoke on this today because, you know, she's searching and asking God and all these beautiful questions. What a sweetheart she has. And, you know, should I just, well, yeah, I'm curious, what is your perspective on being tolerant and all of that kind of stuff, right? And are gay people born gay? You know, they say I was just born that way. And I said, well, yeah, absolutely they were. A religious spirit will tell people, no, it was your choice. Well, yes, that is true. We all have a choice to step out in the desires of our flesh. But I'm going to explain something to you very simple that even a child could understand. Exodus 34, 6 through 9 states this, and the Lord passed by, and he proclaimed, Lord, Lord, God be merciful and gracious, show anger, to slow to anger, abundant in loving kindness and truth, keeping mercy for thousands, forgiving the iniquity. This is Moses again praying in Exodus 34. Be gracious, long-serving, long-suffering, abounding in goodness and truth. Keep mercy for thousands. Forgive the iniquities of their transgressions. By no means clearing the guilty, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children's children to the third and fourth generation. So Moses made haste, and he bowed his head down to the earth, and he worshipped. Now, if I have found grace in your sight, O Lord, let my Lord, I pray, among all of us, even though we're rebellious, we're stiff-necked people, pardon our iniquity and our sin and take us as your inheritance. That's my prayer. Listen, you guys, sins of the fathers are passed down to 3 to 4 generations. Why is it that some of us have a tendency to, we can't just go to a bar, have one drink, we got to do like 50 shots. Why is it that someone can see something evil and just walk away, but someone else has to like keep watching it, or they just have a tendency towards, someone can take a medication for an injury and take one pill and like, okay, I'm good. But how come someone else gets that same injury and now they are addicted to oxycodone? Because you were born with it. See, the sins of the fathers are passed down to 3 to 4 generations. Those iniquities are in our bloodline. So if you are suffering, because this is a huge subject right now, all over the church, all over the news, you know, the transgender bathrooms, homosexuality. We just saw T.D. Jakes. I'm not gossiping. He just did an interview on Huffington Post. You guys can read it. That he's very clear that he... hey, if the homosexual can't find a support in this church, go to another church that does support you. And what the hell? What do you mean church support homosexual? You can read the interview. I'm not here to get into all that. But it's from his own words. I'm not adding to it or taking away. You can surmise what you want to surmise. But he's very clear how he feels with Oprah. And listen, and why they tolerate all of this stuff. And because, hey, we're supposed to love everybody. All right. You know, the Bible's really clear. When you're preaching the cross, it's actually offensive to people. So I don't have a lot of people that really want to hang out with me that aren't on fire. I'm just going to keep that real. Now, a lot of people, they don't come out of my path when I meet them. They love me like, oh my God. But to hang out with me and to be on your talk show and to be on your station and to be a buddy-buddy with you, you're not going to want to be. Because that anointing is actually going to offend you. And you're going to want to run as far away from me as possible. And that's because the Jesus in us can't tolerate sin. We just can't compromise. The Father himself, didn't he turn from the cross when Jesus took on the sins of the world? Why did the Father turn? Oh, the church isn't supposed to turn. We're supposed to welcome it. Did the Father himself welcome it? No, he did not. The Bible says when Jesus took on the sin, the Father had to turn away. Can you imagine? Oh my God. But we have got to understand that we have got to help people, but the only way to help them is with the truth. So if the sins of the fathers are passed down, they're passed down. And so there's answers to what you're suffering. When you desire truth in the inner parts, he makes us to know wisdom in the inmost place. And so I want to share, you know, a couple things about, a couple things here. We want to get in a few little stories to help you out. You guys know we're hashtag the Facebook pastors for a reason. You know, we have different parables, storylines to help teach our students, to help teach our partners. We have things that we like to, different formats in teaching, right? And that's so important because, like my husband always says, you know, the Word of God never changes, but his methods do. So sometimes we need to take different methods to teach people, right? Okay, so when I was preaching in Congo, why is it important to have a leader that seeks favor on your behalf? Why is it important to make sure you're tithing and giving and being obedient and listening to the messages and staying connected with a spiritual leader? Because the Bible says, the Holy Spirit spoke to me this morning, power, purpose, and his presence will be released on your behalf. I release power, purpose, and presence into your life. So when I was in Congo preaching, just thousands of people, they wouldn't leave me alone. They were so hungry. They were desperate to be prayed for. And I wouldn't stop. I just kept going and going and going. And the Congolese pastor got up to the platform. He put his arm around me. He said, listen, you guys, she is a person. She's a woman, not a machine. Wow, did I appreciate that. Don't keep giving, Gina. You need to stop. You're not a machine. You need to end this service and you need to go and rest. That is on the good end. That's a good preacher. That's a good pastor that has covered me. That's an awesome thing because I was in a foreign land. And of course, my spiritual pastors weren't there to say, hey, let her go. She needs to go rest. You guys see, she's about ready to pass out. She's been preaching for 5 hours straight. That was also doing international relief, you know, all over the road. And all right. So your spiritual leader that cares about you is not going to say, give me $1,000. And get online at exactly 5 o'clock every day. And if you miss it, you're out of obedience to a prostitute that needs to be free and not bound by money. The worst thing that could have happened was taking money from someone that pays her Johns, or the Johns pay her. Okay, so then on the other hand, I'm preaching at a church in Corona, and I'm up there preaching. And on a word about who do you say you are, and it was a women's like breakfast. Calm, they're having their a lot of frittata, they're having their cafe, frittatas. Right? Mocha, frittatas, right? It's a women's thing. Everybody's all nice and neat. They got their makeup on, their hair's done, and everybody's got their jewelry, and they look all pretty. So after the message, someone came up and said, will you pray for me? I'm like, well, absolutely. So she comes up, all of a sudden there's a whole line of ladies needing prayer. And I'm just standing there and I'm lifting my hands. They're falling out in the Holy Ghost. They are falling out. They're in fetal position, crying, getting delivered. And the pastor's wife in Corona, and come on, I could be naming names. I mean, come on, Trump is doing it. These are hirelings. They're all over the place, you guys, and stopping the move of God. That is absolutely unbiblical, and it's witchcraft, okay? And so I'm like, they're all falling out, and the pastor's wife comes up and says, listen, I need you to not pray. This is like, no, you need to not do this. I just wanted you to bless them. And I'm like, wait, I'm thinking, I'm a prophet. I don't just bless people. So if somebody comes up and they're a mess, I'm supposed to bless that? Like, no, I pray how God tells me to pray. I'll just bless you, bless you, bless you. And even another one in Corona, a second one had told me, listen, you know, you quit preaching, you quit the altar when there were still people in line. You never do that. You keep praying until people are gone. And I'm thinking, what the hell? You just keep praying. So you want me to pass out until like thousands of people are done being prayed for? Those are not the spiritual leaders you want to be with. But I love when I told my husband about this, I said to him like, oh my God, I told him the story. You know what Pastor Brian said? He said, listen, Gina, what you should have done when she came up to you and said, no, you need to stop right now. Then you should have said, tag, you're in. Tag, you're in.
Hello.
Oh, what the?
Hello.
Who are you? What the?
According to my religious calculations, you should have done a simple prayer and a simple teaching.
I should have done no
laying of hands.
Don't lay hands? Okay, why?
We're on a schedule. We're on a simple religious schedule that doesn't call for the Holy Spirit. Only calls for our simple feelings.
Okay, so there's no Holy Ghost can move. You just want me to pray and keep everybody nice and neat?
Tithe and offerings are approximately, what does she say?
Hello?
Hello.
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 For our listeners on KCWG, I don't know who is this character.
Pastor Shindig.
Pastor Shindig.
Pastor Shindig.
Pastor Shindig. Pastor
Shindig. Wife of Mr. Shindig.
So Pastor Shindig, First Lady of the House, doesn't First Lady doesn't want us to lay hands. Don't let them pray in tongues.
Should have did a wax this morning. Yeah. Should have did a wax this morning.
Don't let them get messed up.
Yeah,
right?
According to my religious calculations, we are on a time schedule.
The church lady right here.
First Lady.
Oh, well, you know what? Can you go get my husband for me, Pastor Brian Warren?
Oh,
because
sure.
We are going to move in the Holy Ghost.
That's
here.
Duty.
Listen, we appreciate your schedule here.
Yes.
We appreciate your, you know, 3-point message and
yes.
A latte, and it's got to be over.
Yes.
But the people that have come to our service, they
yes.
really want deliverance from their pain. So
yes.
You might just want to stick to putting a chicken in the crock pot.
Okay.
Goodbye. All right, put your chicken in the crock pot. All right, Mr. and Mrs. Shindig. All right. And that's what what you're hearing us talk
about. Yeah,
I paid a great price for this message. So what we're explaining to you is this really does happen in the church, you guys. Places I've preached, they've told me, listen, you are, oh, I like this handsome about to take a kiss from this one. Mwah. And that's what they'll tell you,
it's
right?
A crazy lady over there. She's talking about like religious stuff.
Yeah, like it has to go according to plan. But you know what I always say, when people get caught in, Pastor Shindig cracks me up. What people I need to understand is when you get caught in sin, when you're a prostitute laying with a John and you're speaking in tongues because you really are filled with the Holy Ghost while you're with a prostitute, these kinds of things, listen, it's not pretty. It's not pretty when Christians get set in bondage. So it's not going to be pretty when they get set free either, okay? So that's what I want to explain to you. And we wanted to give some real personal stories to let you know what we are seeing and what I've been seeing for many, many years. So when people want to say this is ridiculous, you know, you just want to be kind and you want to be loving. Well, you're not the one on Skype counseling for hours. You know, I had a counseling, or actually my husband and I had a counseling session before we could even leave on our anniversary. And we're counseling these beautiful Team Unbreakable partners. And listen, I'm counseling through some things, and within 10 minutes, you know, I'm praying, and God begins to tell me, Gina, soul ties. So I said, listen, you guys, your previous marriage, did you break those soul ties? I can't, it's too much to get into. I do this in counseling, but when you've been previously married or divorced or widowed or what have you, there's specific ways to pray to release those people and yield them to the Lord. And so they said, well, yeah, we did do that. Actually, we did have a spiritual leader that taught us to do that. And I thought, wow, what am I missing then? Because I know that's what the Lord said. Well, come to find out, the wife then says, listen, actually, somebody's coming to mind. And do you know it's a false prophet that's on Facebook that came to their home and prayed in their house, blessed their home, blessed the marriage, blessed the children. They're all sick. We've had suicide attempts, all kinds of stuff, so much witchcraft you wouldn't imagine. So now I and Pastor Brian had to go back and denounce everything this spiritual leader did in their home and took their money, asked for a certain amount of money. And yes, dear God, you have to understand, you guys, we don't just come on Facebook and preach this stuff all over the place because we just think that the church is messed up. No, we don't think.
We know.
It's messed up.
We got first-hand experience. We diving in there daily.
Oh, yeah.
Before,
oh,
during,
yeah.
And after.
Oh, yeah. The glory
yes.
of God was so on me in this counseling Skype session. I was in tears shaking. My mouth was like, I was shaking so bad with the glory of God. And it's different when you're laying hands and praying for somebody. They're there. But, you know, they're on Skype and, you know, you're either in the U.S. Skyping or they're around the world Skyping. So depending on, you know, sometimes there's pauses when you talk, if they're around, just all this kind of stuff we have to deal with, right? But in the anointing was just breaking. And these people told me they had dreams and visions that night, praying in
Amen.
The Holy Ghost.
Amen.
God set them free. And, you know, but now we can actually counsel and deal with some other issues because we were able to rebuke the pastor, prophet, whatever, that came into their life. Some of you have literally, remember we talked about Pastor Brian, I think it was in our last message, but it was in one of these three on Recognize Your Spiritual Parents. And we talked about that Aaron he proclaimed, tomorrow we'll have a feast. So sometimes a leader can proclaim, make a proclamation that's not of God. And then that proclamation went over your life and now you're sick. Your finances are drained. Your children are cutting. There's all these things because the wrong person proclaims something over your life. Do you know when I was, I think I was about 18, I went to church with a boyfriend that I had had at the time, a spirit-filled church. A prophet prophesied over him and I that we were going to be married, that this was your wife. Gina is your wife. Okay, well, I was still snorting cocaine. Going to sign out on Casey. Oh, my husband's trying to tell. All right, it's only 10 till though. Okay. Okay, got you. So we're going to be closing out on that.
KCWG in about a minute.
In about a minute, we're closing out on KCWG, my husband told me. So I think what we're going to do is I'm going to let my husband close out with our listeners on the radio. We love you guys. But I do want to close because it's going to be up on YouTube. So I do want to tell this story. So, so husband, so thou art my husband.
KCWG, The Truth Radio, we're going to close out with you today, and we are going to continue with you next Thursday, same time, 7 p.m. God bless you all, and thank you. And if this message was a blessing to you, please go to Truth and Love Ministry International Facebook page and click on the donate button.
Or TNLI.org.
Thank you guys very much.
We love you guys.
God bless you all.
Amen, amen. All right, we just closed out on the radio. Thank you, Brian. It is very difficult to stay moving in the spirit when you're on radio time and Facebook time.
Facebook time.
So thank you for the grace, those that watch these videos.
Juggle all these plates.
Yeah, we do really juggle. It's different when I'm at conferences and preaching, and that's a whole different story, right? But I do want to conclude. I want to finish with this story. Amen. Because I'm talking to you about spiritual leaders. They either empower you with power, purpose, and presence released in your on your behalf, or you can be put into bondage on their behalf. Well, hence the White House, the Church House, the Courthouse, right? All three houses are in bondage because somebody proclaimed something that's not right. So someone's got to come in and clean up these three houses.
Amen.
And that's what we're doing. But you know, Pastor Brian, we clean the house with truth. We are Truth in Love Ministry, and we are going to give you the truth. We will always love you. We will always embrace you. Whatever sin you're going through, whatever bondage, we will embrace you. But well, I'm sorry, we've got the door opening, so the dogs are barking. But we will always embrace you with truth because that's what's going to break your bondage, okay? So I wanted to conclude with this particular thing of why it's so important that the right leader is prophesying and speaking the correct things over your life, because I'm going to share this. This boyfriend that I had when I was 18, and this person said that, right? Now, why didn't they say, oh, by the way, if she's going to be your wife, she needs to get free from coke because she's totally addicted to cocaine, right? I mean, but the prophet didn't say that. He just basically said, this is going to be your wife. Well, because I was such a jacked up 18-year-old molested and raped, disowned by my parents, and all those other wonderful things, and addicted to drugs, he obviously wasn't my husband. I was out doing my own thing, and he said, okay, you're all over the place. I'm out of here. Well, what does that do when a man that loves the Lord, he loved the Lord, what does that do to him when somebody prophesied that that was your wife, but I wasn't his wife, right? So now fast forward, I was now married, and I was just praying through some things like, Lord, you know, if there's any soul ties, things that I need to read, blah, blah, blah. So do you know the Lord gave me his name and said, you need to call him? I'm like, oh my gosh, okay. Now at the time, I told my husband at the time, my husband that passed away, I told him, you know, I'm going to call this man, he's married, and I'm going to call him, and I feel like I need to ask him for forgiveness and pray over him, this word that was given to him, because the Lord told me it was actually hindering his marriage with his wife, that he still had soul ties and some feelings for me, okay? So do you know the Holy Spirit gave me his phone number? He gave me his phone number. So I called him. This was years ago. I called him, and he's like, how do you have this number? I said, well, the Holy Ghost. Well, he was a Holy Ghost, spirit-filled, praying in tongues boyfriend at the time. And so I said, you know, Holy Ghost gave this to me, and I just want to ask you for forgiveness for how I broke your heart, you know, the things that I did. I'm so sorry. I was so jacked up, and I asked that you forgive me. And then I said, remember that prophet that said I was your wife and blah, blah, blah. So we prayed together. We prayed. And we released that soul tie, and God set it free. So listen, you guys, I'm sharing some of these personal stories. I have thousands upon thousands of them because life has qualified me, but you know, your life has qualified you. It hasn't disqualified you. The things that you've been through do not negate. They don't make who you are. You can you have to understand that they should never become your personality or your purpose, but it should catapult you into destiny. So we knew that my passion was to deal with false prophets. So of course people call me false prophets. They go on YouTube and you're a false prophet and they say all that kind of stuff, right? Of course those are going to be the accusations because when you're the real thing, that's what they're going to do. But we go after those kinds of things and deal with those issues, you guys. So I want you to understand that Job prayed for his children. And that's why it's so important that we pray for our spiritual children. Pastors, leaders out there, I hope, I pray that you are praying for your partners. Especially, I'm going to say this, whether people like what I'm going to say or not, Brian.
Go for it.
Okay. Especially those that are sowing financially into your ministry. Now, we don't answer all the messages that come to us. We'll get a lot of messages. Oh, can you call me? Can you help me? They've never even sowed a dollar. Can I keep it real?
Please.
Can I keep that real? They've never even given a dollar to the ministry, but they want free counseling or they want a free phone call or they write us on Facebook and ask us to write them back. But you know, come on now. So when your children are obedient and they show respect, thank you, Holy Ghost. He just reminded me of another scripture he wants me to give you in Ephesians 6. And we will close with that scripture. But I think we've been on how long? We've only been on an hour.
Yeah.
Thank you, Jesus. So we really are very timely. It was the radio station because they do a next show and they have to prepare for it. So I think we have like 50 minutes with them or something.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I feel like rushed, but we try to keep the YouTubes right at an hour message. But what I want to say is it's so important that when children are obedient, parents want to help. Parents want to, come on, when our children, like, they clean their room, they go the extra mile, they cut flowers, they put them in your bedroom, your children just do extra things, what I'm saying? It's natural that the parent just wants to just, like, overload and be a blessing. But I want to explain something, and those of you who are parents, I always taught my girls this scripture, because sometimes, your God can't be theirs. They have to learn Jesus for themselves. They will learn and watch your works. They'll watch your fruit. Trust me, they don't do what you do. they don't do what you say. They do what you do, okay? And some of them are doing doo-doo because you're doo-doo, okay? And that's what you're operating in. So then you're wondering why your kids are all jacked up. Okay, that's for someone. But listen, Ephesians 6 says this, children, spiritual children, natural children, let your children know this. Children, obey your parents in the Lord as his representatives. So your physical parents on earth represent the Lord, and your spiritual parents are representatives of the Lord, the ultimate father. And yes, he's also a woman. Oh, what did you just say, Gina? Oh, don't watch this movie, The Shack. Don't do it. It's so heretical. Oh, Jesus shows himself as a woman. Jesus is a spirit, for the love of God, you guys. God is, he created us in his image. Wait, he created us in his image, us. Oh, that means the Chinese, Japanese, Asians, Italians, Mexicans, whites, the men, the women, us.
African American, everybody.
Everybody is created in his image. So, if Satan is an angel of light, he masquerades, and he comes in the form of a pig. He comes in the form of a gorgeous, seductive woman to your husband. He comes in the form of a gorgeous man to the wife. He knows how to take form of that which is seed inside of you that you're going to fall for. All right. Duh. I'd like to say duh. So, Jesus, El Shaddai, the breasty one, okay, he is going to speak to us in ways that we can understand. All right, so God is spirit. All right, so now that we just went over that. So when we see God in heaven, guess what? He is spirit. All right. He took the form of a man on earth. Amen. So children, obey your parents and the Lord, for this is right. Verse 2, honor, esteem, and value as precious your father and mother, for this is the first commandment with a promise. So easy to teach your children this. Listen, you guys, we read the Bible, right, kids? The Bible says that if you obey your parents in the Lord, that this is the right thing. It's the first commandment, but it comes with a promise. So God commands you to obey your parents, but what's the promise? Oh, glad you asked. Let's see what that promise is. Verse 3, that it may be well with you and that you may live long on earth. So I used to tell my kids, oh my gosh, mom, I can't believe this happened at school. And then this is going wrong. And then I failed this test. And then I studied all day. And I said, well, you've been in total rebellion in this home. And the Bible says, children, obey your parents and the Lord, for this is right. So it may go well with you all your days. How was your day? It sucked. Okay, get right. Get right with God. Get right with me, because you're in rebellion and it won't go well all your days. And then it says that you may live long on the earth. Do you know some people are dying premature deaths? It's not going well and they're not living long on the earth. Obey your parents. Obey your father. Obey your mother. I didn't say submit to they abuse you. That's not what I said. Honor and respect, as well as your spiritual parents. Because the title of this message in conclusion is, when your leader, your pastor, seeks favor on your behalf of your sin, because you are in sin, right? We all sin. We all sin and fall short of the glory of God every single day. Okay, that's not, we figured that out. Don't tell me you don't sin. Don't tell me I don't. Don't tell me Pastor Brian doesn't. We all sin and fall short of the glory of God. Sin is missing the mark. Did you miss the mark today? Then you sinned. Did I miss the mark today? Then I sinned. So on your behalf, power, purpose, and presence will be released, because we cover your sin in Jesus' name. Every mistake that you made today, every bad attitude, when you opened your mouth and gossiped and slandered, when you watched something you shouldn't have watched, when you read something you shouldn't have read, when you had a wrong attitude, you looked twice, you thought about it, you looked, now it's in your heart, you know, and you turned your heart from God. I cover that. Pastor Brian covers that in Jesus' name. We ask the favor of God be upon your life. We ask now, Lord Jesus, that you would remember our Team Unbreakables. We ask that you remember their offerings and their gifts unto you and to this ministry, to their spiritual parents. And we ask that you remember that and that you would forgive them and cover them in the blood of Jesus. Amen. I think that's ministering to somebody. Because it releases us from feeling guilty. Your spiritual parents should love you unconditionally. Oh, but listen, but that's with a promise. There comes a promise when we're obedient. So when we obey, the Lord forgives us. It's obedience. He desires obedience is greater than sacrifice, for sacrifice is a sin of divination. That's what it says in 1 Samuel. So we could be operating in divination, in witchcraft, without even knowing it. So that's the thing. Your spiritual parents know what you don't. You know, we pray for you guys. We look at your posts on Facebook. We see your pictures. We see your remarks. Not just us. We watch things. And we watch so we know where there's wrong attitudes. We know when there's pride coming in. We know when you're getting a little bit like, oh, I'm just going to, you know, yield my sword at people. And you become a little religious. We can see that. And we pray for you that the Lord would forgive you and that your attitude would be corrected quickly. Amen. And don't you worry about correcting us. Don't do it. We have spiritual parents that do that. Trust me. Right? So we have that accountability. You are just to be obedient to the Lord and ask the Lord who your spiritual parents are, because you do need to find them. You've been orphaned. You are an illegitimate child if you do not have a spiritual parent. You have been orphaned and you're not protected. You are not protected. And you get your protection when you get in line and you get in position with your spiritual parent, the right one. And ask the Lord to lead you and guide you to the right one. They won't do you wrong. I really believe that in this season, God is raising up true leaders with hearts that bleed for the people. But they're such strong warriors, they won't allow you to compromise, because if they do allow you just a little bit, a little leaven will just ruin the whole loaf. Amen. So trust your spiritual parents. You know, trust us, and I know a lot of you do. We love you guys, and we appreciate you. And I think that that's.
I gotta give one analogy. When I first became a professional fighter, first of all, I saw it on TV and thought, "Oh, wow, I want to do that." Okay, until someone gets punched in the face for real, it looks a lot easier on TV than it does in person, right?
That's true. Amen. All right? Yeah.
I saw Top Gun. I wanted to be a fighter pilot. I saw Days of Thunder. Wanted to be a race car driver. Saw UFC on TV. Oh, I want to be a fighter. Okay, 4 days later, the Lord allowed me the phone call to come in. Hey, Brian, you want to come down to TJ in Tijuana, Mexico, and fight? Scared to death. Started reading my Bible. Oh, I can't believe this. I accepted the challenge. Yeah, it's for real. I'm going down to fight a guy that's been training for a couple years, and I'm going to go against a pro. Mm-hmm. So that being said, I got my butt kicked, all right, the first time. I didn't like that very much. So I decided to train, find a local gym. Well, that judo studio that I trained at, there's a black belt in there. I trained. I did really well. Outgrew the studio. Looked for a professional fighting team
Amen.
That could take me to the next level.
Amen.
I went to that team. The lowest guy on the bottom of the totem pole. I was getting my butt kicked daily.
Good.
Okay? Mm-hmm. Daily. But I kept going back and kept going back. Pretty soon, before you know it, I started climbing up, and started beating a lot of the guys in the class.
Amen.
Started traveling around the world, fighting in Vegas and all over the world, everywhere. But here's the thing. We went to that school. You were more afraid of practice than you were the actual fight that you were going to go into next
preach.
Week. Because
Be more afraid
that
of
trainer
practice.
Was no joke. You were going to fight for real. You were going to learn how to really get in there and do it. And he was making sure that I wasn't going to get embarrassed inside the ring when I got in there. I was going to get embarrassed in class.
There you go.
And it was all the little details that I needed to learn were getting refined in that class.
Yes.
And I became so strong that I became one of the top fighters out there and started fighting the top
Amen.
Fighters in the world.
Amen.
So that hopefully that ministers to somebody.
It does.
But
you need to
have somebody that's over looking at you and watching you and sharpening you up. If you're not getting sharp, if you don't have a leader that's sharpening you up and teaching you and teaching you new things and holding you accountable, you're gonna go and do what you want. And your training is not gonna be.
Yeah, and when they get to the platform of life, what God has called them to do, they will be embarrassed and they will not be ready.
Oh,
so,
yeah.
Like one of our partners said, focus. She said, focus. It's so
focus.
Important that
Discipline.
You focus and be disciplined and listen to what we're teaching you. We're not here just to give a good Bible study. We're giving a now word that'll be a platform like a diving board. So when you spring off of the diving board of Truth and Love Ministry International, you dive straight into the pool of the greatness that God has for you. And you'll be able to do all the laps, do all the swimming, all the technique. You can hold your breath. You can keep going. We're going to train you in the spirit to go as long as you can and have the endurance. And
right.
That's what we need as believers in this end time. So we want to thank all of our listeners.
If I can give you guys one thing that I've learned in the spiritual in the fighting ring, and I've transferred it to the spiritual, what I'm able to teach somebody right now is focus, discipline.
Focus.
They say, my wife says, focus anger. You know, I see your face when you're walking to the ring or the cage, and you're in there, and you're super focused. You're not worried about the crowd, what they're saying, or anything like that. You're just focused on what you have ahead of you. And you keep that focus because if you get distracted, you're taken out, right? Oh,
okay.
Smoke screen over here. But stay focused, stay disciplined, guard your eyes, guard your mind. There's sounds and there's voices coming in all the time, guys. Know which ones to turn on and which ones to turn off.
That's right.
Father, in the name of Jesus,
thank
Father, we
Jesus.
Want to thank you, Lord, for this teaching today. We
thank
want to thank you for our Team Unbreakable partners. We want to thank you for everybody listening and watching today. I pray a blessing over everybody. And I just thank you, Lord, if this is your ministry, this is the ministry that you sow to financially, I pray a blessing, tenfold blessing over everybody.
Thank you, Jesus.
That begins to trust us and sow into this ministry. We thank you, Lord. Bless them and bless them.
Bless them
in Jesus'
mighty
name.
We love you guys.
Amen.
Until next time, God bless you.
Amen. Wait.
Yes. Oh, goodness.
It's our anniversary, 2-year anniversary.
Woo-hoo!
God bless you guys.